Congressman Louie Gohmert, Republican, Texas, joins us now from Capitol Hill. Louie, your reaction to this hardline ending of the June 12th summit.
Well, Stuart, this is the thing I really appreciate about Donald Trump. He's not being Jimmy Carter or Bill Clinton or Hillary Clinton or John Kerry or Obama and going rushing over to beg totalitarian evil people to please, please, please let us work out some deal. That is not what he does. He doesn't go running to the Middle East and looking for people he can bow to. He says what he's going to do, and then he does it.
Okay.
And that's something that Kim Jong Un, Kim Jong Il, wherever those guys may be, they can count on Donald Trump. He is going to do what he's said he's going to do.
Would you hold on a second, because I'm just getting some response from leading Democrats, specifically Senate Minority Leader Charles Schumer. He just tweeted this. Many of us feared that the summit between POTUS, President of the United States, and Kim Jong-un would be a great show that produced nothing enduring. If a summit is to be reconstituted, the U.S. must show strength and achieve a concrete, verifiable, enduring elimination of Kim Jong-un's nuclear capabilities. You heard it, Louie. What do you make of it?
I'm just so grateful that Chuck Schumer is so consistent. I think that is his greatest attribute. But unfortunately, it puts him in the category as all the naysayers when Reagan was trying to work out deals. And when he walked away from Reykjavik, you know, and all people like that think like Schumer were just, oh, it's at the end of the world, it's the worst thing, not realizing that what Reagan did in turning around and walking away, saying, no, we're not going to give up on something that important, ended up bringing down the Soviet Union, making America stronger than it had ever been. That is, until Bill Clinton and Obama got through with us.
Okay, so look, the summit is off. We don't know any response yet from North Korea.
Oh, listen, let me tell you, it won't be off permanently, because North Korea is going to find out now what he didn't realize was that Trump was serious about. There will be a price that North Korea will pay, and Donald Trump will lead us in getting that price for them, and then it will be the North Korean leader that will come back begging to have some kind of talk.
What do you think the next step is?
I think it is immediately taking steps to, just like Trump is talking about with Iran, putting the toughest sanctions they can imagine, turning up the heat even more on China. You know, there's a lot of things we can do to put the heat on China. For example, if we go bankrupt here in the United States, then China immediately falls, and there's a big revolution there in China, and those people in charge are run out on a rail. So they don't have quite the leverage they think they have, and Trump is going to use all the leverage we've got. I'm so proud. He's president now. Hillary's not. We're not going to rush over there and give them bigger and better nukes if they'll just promise not to use them. That's what Hillary would be doing if she were president.
You know, Louie, I think you just said it all, didn't you? I mean, that's a very accurate expression of your personal opinion, and I think it's probably shared by a great many Americans.
I believe that's where we're looking at. So I'm looking forward to the sanctions and the Kim Jong-un family finding out just how serious we are now with a serious president.
Got it. Louie, thanks as always for being with
us. Great to be with you. And the stock market will come back up once they see how serious this guy is.
Okay,
it's good.
We'll take that.
It's going to be good.
Okay.
Meanwhile, President Trump has gotten himself into not a pickle, out of a pickle, I would suggest. So I have always been skeptical of the idea that there was going to be a grand summit between the Trump administration and the North Korean dictatorship. I have always been deeply skeptical of this. I was from the beginning when people were shouting Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize. I was saying, for what? Okay, unless North Korea wants to actually give something up, there's no deal that's going to get done here, and there's a far better shot that the United States will make a bad move, and that the bad move will involve pulling troops off the peninsula, or scaling down military drills, or making some sort of promise financially to Kim Jong-un, which I do not support. Well, President Trump did the right thing. So, a few days ago, North Korea threatened a nuclear showdown with the United States. So this was just a couple of days ago. North Korea, according to Huffington Post, has escalated its war of words with the U.S., repeating a threat on Thursday to call off the planned June 12th summit with President Donald Trump, warning that a nuclear showdown could instead be on the table. In a statement published by North Korea's official Korean Central News Agency, the North's Vice Minister of Public Affairs, Cho Sun-hui, blamed reckless remarks made by top U.S. officials as the reason behind Pyongyang's second thoughts. Cho took aim at VP Mike Pence in particular and called him a political dummy who defended North Korea with his unbridled and imprudent comments, and impudent comments, rather. Pence had warned in a Fox News interview that Pyongyang could follow the Libya model if Kim Jong Un doesn't make a deal, which was a deal where Muammar Gaddafi met a brutal end after his decision to denuclearize. Okay, North Korea has long expressed distaste at comparisons with Libya. They don't want to look like a weak country that gave up their nuclear weaponry and all the rest. So they were ripping on Mike Pence, and they were suggesting that they were going to pull out of the June 12th summit. And so Trump came out and he wrote a letter, and his letter basically said, fine, stay home, I don't care, which is exactly right. That's exactly right. Okay, the United States is not the country in trouble here. The country in trouble here is North Korea. And let's face the reality. North Korea is in trouble because they blew up their own nuclear mountain. It collapsed in on them weeks ago. They do not have a nuclear testing site inside North Korea because they had a physical problem with their nuclear testing site. It broke. Okay, they broke their own testing site, which is an amazing thing. And President Trump was just sitting there. And then they're like, can we have some talks? He's like, absolutely, you can have some talks. And then in order to save face, they're making all sorts of noises about nuclear war. So President Trump, this is where President Trump's habit of being just a bloviating hammer of a human being, it really comes in handy. So here is what he wrote. You have to love this. It's so good. He writes, dear Mr. Chairman, we greatly appreciate your time, patience, and effort with respect to our recent negotiations and discussions relative to a summit long sought by both parties, which was scheduled to take place on June 12th in Singapore. We were informed the meeting was requested by North Korea, but that to us is totally irrelevant. I was very much looking forward to being there with you. Sadly, based on the tremendous anger and open hostility displayed in your most recent statement, I feel it is inappropriate at this time to have this long-planned meeting. Therefore, please let this letter serve to represent that the Singapore summit, for the good of both parties, but to the detriment of the world, will not take place. You talk about your nuclear capabilities, but ours are so massive and powerful that I pray to God they will never have to be used. Okay, that last sentence is so Trump. It's so Trump, and it's so great. I mean, it's like Donald Trump brags about his genitals and his nuclear capabilities in exactly the same one. They're so massive and powerful. I pray to God they will never have to be used. It's just spectacular. It's so good. Right? I mean, it's the president of the United States telling North Koreans, guys, like, let's be real here. You're pretending that this is a partnership of co-equals, that we're going to sit down across the table and we're going to pretend like North Korea is a real country and not a crazy dictatorship where you imprison in a gulag hundreds of thousands of people and then test your crappy level nuclear weapons. Like, we're going to pretend that. But let's be real. We're massive. We're huge, you might say. And then he continues. I felt a wonderful dialogue was building up between you and me. And ultimately, it is only that dialogue that matters. Someday, I look very much forward to meeting you. In the meantime, I want to thank you for the release of the hostages who are now home with their families. That was a beautiful gesture and was very much appreciated. Which is him reminding them, you guys already made concessions to me. So ha, 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 ha. You idiots. You let out the hostages, and now we're not going to do a meeting, and I'm going to laugh about how my nuclear weapons are better than yours. Okay, all of this is kind of hilarious. Okay, let's be real. Kind of funny. Does it increase the chances of nuclear war? No, because the North Korean regime does not want to get into nuclear war with the United States. We would turn his palace into an ocean of glass in 30 seconds flat. This is not happening, okay? There's not going to be a war between North Korea and the United States because Kim Jong-un is not suicidal. And all of the concessions he was prepared to make were not going to be made because Donald Trump sweet-talked him. This is never going to be about Donald Trump being able to cut a better deal than anyone else or anything like that. Okay, the art of negotiation does not lie in you giving somebody a pat on the head and a shoulder rub. That's not how negotiation works. The way it works is Trump is ready to walk away from the table. Okay, this is true for your salary negotiations at your own company. It is true for everyone. You have to decide in your own head, what is your walkaway point? What is the point where you say, listen, this is not worth it for me, I'm out. Trump knew that his walkaway point was pretty much anything. That if North Korea decided to make trouble, he was just going to say, fine, screw it. Enjoy your poverty-stricken country. We're out. And if you make trouble, well, guess what? Our military threat is still on the table. He continues along these lines. If you change your mind having to do with this most important summit, please do not hesitate to call me or write. The world, and North Korea in particular, has lost a great opportunity for lasting peace and great prosperity and wealth. This missed opportunity is a truly sad moment in history. Sincerely yours. And then it's the biggest signature ever. Like, you almost have to see the signature. It's like the entire page. It's like President Trump was like, you know what? Just to So Kim Jong Un doesn't need to use his reading glasses. He's gonna sign this huge spiky signature, the Donald Trump signature. Okay. You can hate Donald Trump as much as you want. That's pretty great stuff. This is what he is supposed to do. What's hilarious is folks on the left are saying, "How could Donald Trump do this? How could look?" It just shows how Donald Trump blew it. Now, here's where Donald Trump went wrong. He shouldn't have been running around talking about how he was going to win the Nobel Prize for meeting with Kim Jong Un beforehand, but that's Trump's thing. Okay, are we going to pretend for half a second here that President Trump isn't the guy who walks around bragging about everything? Have you met him? Have you seen him? Of course, as soon as people started saying Nobel Prize, he was going to go around talking about how he was about to win 8 Nobel Prizes in physics, in literature, all of them, right? He was going to, like, that was going to happen. But here's the, I thought that that was trapping him in a situation where he was going to have more stake in having the meeting than in getting something good out of the meeting. That obviously was not true. So if I sound relieved, it's because I am. President Obama was not like this. President Obama was willing to grant every shred of credibility he could.
I'm just stopping by to remind you that liberals are insane. Social justice warriors are becoming more violent and triggered than ever before. Anyways, be sure to subscribe to KGP TV on YouTube and have a blessed day. Yeah, man.
Congressman Louie Gohmert, Republican, Texas, joins us now from Capitol Hill. Louie, your reaction to this hardline ending of the June 12th summit.
Well, Stuart, this is the thing I really appreciate about Donald Trump. He's not being Jimmy Carter, Bill Clinton, or Hillary Clinton, or John Kerry, or Obama, and going rushing over to beg totalitarian evil people to please, please, please let us work out some deal. That is not what he does. He doesn't go running to the Middle East and looking for people he can bow to. He says what he's going to do, and then he does it.
Okay.
And that's something that Kim Jong Un, Kim Jong Il, wherever those guys may be, they can count on Donald Trump. He is going to do what he's said he's going to do.
Would you hold on a second, because I'm just getting some response from leading Democrats, specifically.
Now with a serious president.
Got it. Louie, thanks as always for being with
us. Great to be with you.
Appreciate it.
And the stock market will come back up once they see how serious this guy is.
Okay,
it's good.
We'll take that.
It's going to be good.
Okay.
Meanwhile, President Trump has gotten himself into not a pickle, out of a pickle, I would suggest. So I have always been skeptical of the idea that there was going to be a grand summit between the Trump administration and the North Korean dictatorship. I have always been deeply skeptical of this. I was from the beginning when people were shouting Nobel Prize, Nobel Prize. I was saying, for what? Okay, unless North Korea wants to actually give something up, there's no deal that's going to get done here, and there's a far better shot that the United States will make a bad move, and that the bad move will involve pulling troops off the peninsula, or scaling down military drills, or making some sort of promise financially to Kim Jong-un, which I do not support. Well, President Trump did the right thing. So, a few days ago, North Korea threatened a nuclear showdown with the United States. So this was just a couple of days ago. North Korea, according to Huffington Post, has escalated its war of words with the U.S.
Saying, no, we're not going to give up on something that important. Ended up bringing down the Soviet Union, making America stronger than it had ever been. That is, until Bill Clinton and Obama got through with us.
Okay, so look, the summit is off.
Yep.
We don't know any response yet from North Korea.
Oh, listen, let me tell you, it won't be off permanently, because North Korea is going to find out now what he didn't realize was that Trump was serious about. There will be a price that North Korea will pay, and Donald Trump will lead us in getting that price for them, and then it will be the North Korean leader that will come back begging to have some kind of talk.
What do you think the next step is?
I think it is immediately taking steps to, just like Trump is talking about with Iran, putting the toughest sanctions they can imagine, turning up the heat.
Senate Minority Leader Charles Schumer, he just tweeted this. Many of us feared that the summit between POTUS, President of the United States, and Kim Jong Un would be a great show that produced nothing enduring. If a summit is to be reconstituted, the U.S. must show strength and achieve a concrete, verifiable, enduring elimination of Kim Jong Un's nuclear capabilities. You heard it, Louie. What do you make of it?
I'm just so grateful that Chuck Schumer is so consistent. I think that is his greatest attribute. But unfortunately, it puts him in the category as all the naysayers when Reagan was trying to work out deals. And when he walked away from Reykjavik, you know, and all people like that think like Schumer were just, oh, it's at the end of the world, it's the worst thing, not realizing that what Reagan did in turning around and walking away, even more on China, you know, there's a lot of things we can do to put the heat on China. For example, if we go bankrupt here in the United States, then China immediately falls. And there's a big revolution there in China, and those people in charge are run out on a rail. So they don't have quite the leverage they think they have. And Trump is going to use all the leverage we've got. I'm so proud. He's president now. Hillary's not. We're not going to rush over there and give them bigger and better nukes if they'll just promise not to use them. That's what Hillary would be doing if she were president.
You know, Louie, I think you just said it all, didn't you? I mean, that's a very accurate expression of your personal opinion, and I think it's probably shared by a great many Americans.
I believe that's where we're looking at. So I'm looking forward to the sanctions and the Kim Jong Un family finding out just how serious we are now.